It's not just agriculture. We see these going down the road every day. You see the ones on the interstate that have 20 axles, destroying our roads, ruining our county roads, our township roads. But as we get down further into the presentation, we're going to look at those big trucks. And we're going to look at how agriculture has changed, I think, for the better. Let that sink in a little bit. No pun intended. Brown County, South Dakota, right there. Brown County had miles and miles and miles of this in 2010. They're still recovering from it. That takes a long time. I work really closely with the highway superintendents, and I know Dirk really well at Brown County. It's a battle every day, every single day. And he's not the only county out there that has that fight. It's in the cities also. You heard him talk earlier about now we get 200-year rains a year, or 350-year rains a year. We've had more catastrophic flooding at the county level probably in the last 10 years than we did in 40 years prior to that. Is it all weather related, or have we changed something? We've changed a lot of things, haven't we? You go to City of Sioux Falls and you wonder why they flood. There's nowhere for water to go anymore. Water does not absorb into grass or into concrete like it does grass. We've tiled. We've put more water in our creeks. We've done a lot of things that make that 20 and 50 year event a lot worse than it should be. 20 year life cycle costs, when people always say, well, just pave it and be done with it. If we figure a 20 year life cycle cost, a lot of us can afford $100,000 over 20 years. How often are we going to go out and pave 1 mile? If we need to get from point A to B, it's usually a 5 or 6 mile project. So now we got a budget, $3.5 million over 20 years for 1 6-mile segment of road. We talked about turning some of these roads back to gravel. How many live on an oil road in here? A few. How many would like to live on a gravel road instead? None? I agree. But what do you do with a roadway like this when we just looked at $575,000 over the lifetime of that mile? Do we turn it back to gravel? Who wants that? That gets 2,000 cars a day. That's not a candidate to turn back to gravel. We need to figure out how to fix that. We need to figure out how to make that a value to 2,500 cars a day. Now, is this one? This one doesn't even look as worse, as bad, does it? Or similar. Is that a candidate to go back to gravel? Absolutely. If you aren't putting 200 cars a day on that roadway, you should consider having a gravel road. It's just that much cheaper to maintain. South of Warner, 10 years ago it was asphalt. Then it turned back to gravel. Now it's going back to dirt. We're not changing that, it's just digressing to that point. Will it ever be asphalt again? I would highly doubt it. Wheel taxes. I haven't updated this since we did this work. You won't see any fives on here, but some have went to $5. Increased wheel tax to increase revenue for road and bridge. Not popular. Not with your constituents, is it? But what we're seeing, and I'll use my home county for example, a $2 rate, we've got a structure there that I know has been on the books for a long time. It's on a road that goes to a train loading facility. During harvest, I've counted 120 to 150 trucks a day on that bridge, and it's posted. But the way the new bridge program is set up, that bridge is number 37 or 39 on the list of bridges by importance. If Girald County would raise their wheel tax on vehicles over 6,000 pounds to the $5 maximum, that would give them enough points in the rating system to go from like 37 up to 9. So that's something you got to sell if you're an elected official and you're not at the max. That's probably going to be a $300,000 bridge replacement. We can either wait 10, 12 years until it comes up on the cycle and we're going to be 30 or 40% more cost, or we can raise taxes on the wheels, get the bridge done. There's nothing in law that says once you put a $5 tax on, you have to leave it there. Maybe use that as a special provision to get a big project done. You township folks, you have a 50 cents per thousand that you can use. Just because you put it on one time doesn't mean you need to leave it on for road and bridge. But if you've got a big project to do, maybe 1 year. Get with your people in your township. I hear people all the time that tell me township government's inefficient. It might be, but you know what? Township government also is one that takes care of themselves. If you guys have a project that has to get done, you tax yourself, don't you? If you did that same project on the county system and you went for an opt-out, you got about a 40% chance of it not being referred and not making it. That's because everyone in the county is worried about where that money's going to get spent. At the township level, you know, don't you? That's your money, you're going to spend it in your township, and you're going to help your people. So that's why it's so much easier for you. Overview of the bridge deficiencies, costs, needs, wants, the future of the program. All things that, I mean, we look at it every year. There's not a simple solution out there. Number of county and city structures, 3,900. Number of obsolete or deficient bridges is almost 30%. Approximately number closed, there's 73, which is only 2%. 1,084 structures need to replace. Average cost, and this has went up since then, and that's where we get the $249 million. Here's where the problem is, folks. See how many bridges were built back in this time frame? They're all coming due at once. That is the problem with our bridge program. We weren't able to fund that sufficiently year after year after year. Many of these kept on a downward trend until now we've got a whole bunch of them that need done at one time. Ongoing bridges, over the next 30 years, we're going to add another 1,300 bridges to that that are going to become deficient. We've got, yep. I would just said we just park that there and build a step to it. That would be the best. It is dumb, but it happens everywhere. I was in Bismarck yesterday doing some classes, and one of the guys in front of me was doing a class about bridges, and they showed a picture of a motor grader that the back end had fell through, and it was standing straight up and down in the bottom of a creek. That motor grader weighs 40,000 pounds, and the bridge posting sign said 4 tons. You can risk that. People drive overloaded over bridges all the time. Do we know when it's going to collapse? You don't. When you hear the crash. Or when you say, oh, and you know you're headed down, right? It was. Yep.
It is. Beat it up pretty good. I don't know if it destroyed it or not.
Here's a picture of the pie chart. Not every county is going to be exactly the same as this, but this is going to be pretty close. Township levy, you get all 4% of that. But that's something that you need to know as an elected official. It's amazing how many times I go and work with elected officials that they don't really actually know where their money's being spent. The auditor might know. The auditors know everything. I'm going to tell you that right now. It is their job to know where that money goes. Whether they want to share that with you, that's up to them. Township inventory. I wish I would have brought a couple gifts today. I would ask you, of all the roads in South Dakota, what percent do you think belong to the locals? That's city, county, and townships. How many? 90% or near it belong to the locals. What percentage of traffic belongs to the locals? Exactly right. Locals have 90% of the roadways, but we only carry 10% of the traffic. That's why we spend so much money on the state system, because they are carrying almost 90% of all the traffic. Yes. I don't know if we need toll roads. Yeah, we're not going to talk about that. That's I've been drug into that before, and we're not going to even discuss that. Here's something interesting on the township systems. What we inventoried back in 2014, you guys have about 1,820 what we consider to be small structures. So anything that's less than 20 feet in length from where you drive on to where you drive off the bridge, you see a wooden one out there on the township system that's not 20 foot long, it's going to change your thought process forever. That is not a bridge. I don't care if it looks like a bridge, smells like a bridge, feels like a bridge. If it's less than 20 feet, it's a culvert. But here we defined them as small structures, just because we needed a number in there. Where the problem is at right now is in the township systems, we've got 1,820 of these little wooden structures or little box culverts, things like that, that are out there. You know how many of them are getting looked at every year and inspected? Almost none. So at the township level, now you're taking the risk. If you've got a small structure and you don't post it for weight, you're telling that truck that's coming down the road or the hay hauler coming down the road that that structure is legally load approved.